built on the Lexus University. Mr. Kuznetsov has been working for some motor graduate stock since the foundation of PDM for long-term relations with Silicon Valley. We join in welcoming Mr. Kuznetsov.
Hello, everybody. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Good. At the beginning, I'd like to express my gratitude to the organizers for the opportunity given to me to attend this meeting, to stay on the stage in front of you. It is very special for me because I live in Asia, nearby Tokyo, not far, just 1 hour flight. Yes. And although I look Asian, but really I live an Asian life because we all have like Oriental hemisphere, we eat Oriental food, I like Korean. And on occasions we go to Thailand, China, Korea, Singapore, Hong Kong, no, never to Europe. It's too far and too costly. Yeah, and you can hardly find people in my town who can speak German or Italian, but many people speak Korean, Chinese, I speak Japanese. I'm Asian. But today I have a feeling, a very special feeling, that I belong to something big and global named Sumitomo Europe. Gosh, I'm European. I want to bring this feeling to my people back home and to share with them. Well, presentation. The name of presentation is 26 Years History of Success. It's kind of strange to make it after Michael just yesterday explained us, he's a big cardinal hater, he explained us that this business model is dying, already dead, and now I'm here with my success stories. Glad you Anyways, the presentation is made, let me go through, and the history is really 26 years, and we started like in 1992 as a joint venture, 50-50, Sumitomo Shoji and the local company. I belonged to the local company then, and we were like four people. We started from four people, three Russians and one Japanese at the time. Company grew up, and today we are 449 Russians and only one Japanese. Japanese don't grow. I don't know why. Maybe it's our Kaizen point. And today we are like two companies occupying the big territory of the fires of Russia. We are selling, we will represent Toyota and Lexus for outlets, and making a sales turnover of 15 billion rubles. I believe this figure tells nothing to you. It's, but it's 230 million years. And with general sales of about 2.5%. Then, why we could, and there are some steps of our success and growth, success, development and growth till today. Today it is 100% owned by Sumitomo Corporation. And why we could go through those 26 years and still be alive? Because of our understanding what we are. We know that we are the strongest American company in the market. And I would like to say that we know what we are going to be, but still it's a little bit unclear for us because of paradigm change. But what is the main? The main is that we know our mission, why we are existing for in the market. This is our customers, and this is customer satisfaction, just to provide some value to the customers so that they would stay with us forever and let our company live forever, possibly. Well, this is what Sebastian called the headache country. It's Russia and the Russian market. It is much dependent, Russian economy is much dependent on oil prices in the world, and you know, it's due to structural crisis and some political reasons. Economy is now just not so good. I would say stagnating. And over here, there is just the end of the market. The market in Russia, in the best times, like in 08 and 2012, reached almost 3 million cars. It's close to Japan or maybe Germany. Recently, it is 50% of it. 50%. It's like this year it's gonna be like 1.8, and our distributor Toyota Russia focused, well, slight picking up in the coming years, but still stagnating. Then this is the market of the Far East. Same trend. We now are like 50% of previous years. And I will move to another slide. It shows just the difference or uniqueness of the market in the Far East. You may see that it's really huge territory. Many European countries can be placed here. And quite recently, a couple of weeks ago, Putin signed an order, and two more adjacent regions are attached now to the Far East. So it is like 40% of the entire country is space, and population is about 6%. Together with new regions, it is like maybe now about 7 million. And just to tell you, to remind you, the population of Russia is about 145 million in total. And we are here, and what is the peculiarity? As in Bulgaria, our car park, or we call it units in operation, is pretty old. In the Far East here, we have about 2 million cars, and 90% of them are, I think, Japanese. Passenger cars, Japanese, came to Russia as imported second-hand cars, right-hand drive, and 46%, or half of it, Toyota. And for many years, loyalty to the brand is very high. And this is our merit. But as I told you, well, half of those second-hand cars is older than 20 years. And what is also unique for us, to compare with other regions in Russia, that SUV vehicles are very popular. More than half of our sales comes to big SUVs. At the same time, other dealers in Russia say like 25-28% in total. Those SUVs bring us some benefits because bigger SUVs are normally more expensive. It gives us more sales and VHP. Yes, and this is about us, Summit Motors Group in the Far East. But it happens to be that this is our market share change. And look, in 2016, even now, we occupied about half of the market, competing against all other brands. We have 50% of all the market. It means no way to grow, almost. While Toyota in Russia, in total sales, amount like 1.8 million Toyota sales, or Toyota share is about 6% only. We have 50% in the market. And this year, we are lucky, and we are going to overachieve our sales plans, both Toyota and Lexus. Next. This is kind of a roadmap of how we see our future development. And of course, it's vertical development, horizontal development. Vertically, we're just improving our qualities, job process qualities, and new functions of the company, and the personnel qualities. Horizontally, just quantitatively, we are looking to adjacent areas. Actually, we are losing our customers, those who buy cars from us and go to smaller towns and never come to us for maintenance or repair. Just we are reinforcing our presence here through our agents. And another one is, well, innovative. This all we need about innovations. We are still conventional, very classic, old school model. But we are thinking about that. And this kind of, points, we try to specify exact points where we collect data from. Data like customer data, like customer driving data, so that we could more clearly understand customers' needs, the customers' expectations, wants, so that we could generate new values for them. And we started. I wouldn't say it's innovative, but you know that car dealer domain is 3S. This is sales of cars, spare parts, and service. So besides that, we studied rent, car rent, quite naturally when the customer leaves the car for repair for 1-2 days in his car. At Lexus it's okay because we have some substitution car, replacement car for him for those days, but for Toyota, no. So we just offered some cars, and that can be easily because we have some fleet of test drive cars, and we have to replace them every year to sell. Or we have company cars, we also replace the unit cars. So we use those cars now, and we have started just from 20 units, 10 units in each town, in Kabardino-Stok and Khabarovsk, and offering to the customers, and studying who, where to go, why, for how long. We just start collecting data about that. Yeah. Well, this is just a short trend and a long trend. Short trend, I told you, this is just for customers. And well, it's new, almost new to us, and it's good for customers. And this is from 3 hours to 1 month. And then long rental, we call, well, it's just like a lease. And we have a customer who already got from us a dozen of vehicles, and paying it. So it's quite beneficial for them because, well, they have an advantage. Well, it's simpler payment, they use all these new vehicles, and just we help them to manage the fleet. And for them, since it's much healthier, rather than have some excessive assets, they just put it into tents. And for us, it's also some new profit source. Of course, it's not a big profit from operating the project itself, but it may come in the way of high residual value of Toyota. Residual value of Toyota is much higher than Mercedes, for example. And in 5 years, after the car value is totally depreciated from your books, and the book value is zero, but still, condition for the car is pretty good. We take care of the cars, we maintain and repair them, and even after that, we still even can sell it to the market and get some surplus or use it for further rent or maybe car sharing, what's become popular by that time. So, we go next, well, about innovations. That is Starline. It's an alarm system, security system provided to the cars and quite popular over the market. And we are equipping those cars that we provide to the customers, especially those fleets who rent for long. And it helps them, we believe it may help them. Today we just collect data about remotely, we can control the car, or just we know the car behavior that's on the road, driving style, or we may help to the customer to understand where is his car and the history, all those kinds, or security services. So, so far, there are so much data provided by Starline or such telematic systems, and we are sorting out and thinking what kind of data could be useful for the customer, just to give them new values and to be more effective and efficient in their operations. Actually, that is all from my side. And well, we are 26 years, and my message to both you guys is that in spite of this age, we are still very young. We are here and here, and as Michael said, I'm 34 for almost 20 years. That means that me and my team, we are very open to all innovative, and we bravely accept anything. And this is my appeal to all of Sumitomo Group companies or regional offices, that we are ready to collaborate on anything, even beyond our domain, car business, anything, guys. And now I'd just like to entertain you and show you a short video. There was no photos, remember? No pictures, no photos of our premises or people. No, not to imitate Michael, because he hates dealership. But there is a video. Video shows some job processes, a little bit of premises, job processes, how we sell, how we repair cars, how we trade in. And there are my people, my colleagues, not a single professional actor. So please enjoy.
Can copy the dance during the lunch.